inductee, Alan Hayes.
And it is my honor to present the Hayes Medal.
I want to commend all those who had the vision to form the Marshall County Sports Hall of Fame organization. And I want to thank all those who have served in a leadership role during the past 15 years. And I want to express my respect and appreciation to all of the athletes, past and present, who have shed sweat, blood, and tears while developing the skills which made each deserving of the honor of being inducted into the Marshall County Sports Hall of Fame. All athletes are tremendous role models for the school population of Marshall County, and every student and every community is a better place because of the because of the attention that you folks have caused to be focused on team sports. At Boys High School in the 1942-43 school year and through the 1946-47 school year, my years there at Boys High School, with one year out of service in the Navy, our facilities were very poor or non-existent. We had two team sports, football and basketball, for boys. Absolutely no competitive sports for girls, zero. By comparison today, Boys High School, I'm told, has 8 competitive sports teams for girls. Our gym was constructed of pine board siding, unpainted. Unpainted. The interior walls unfinished, one pot-bedded stove, no hot water, no gym finish on the playing floor. Each player purchased his own shoes. Our football practice field was about 5 blocks from the school campus in an old cornfield, and I can assure you that we did not ride a bus to and from practice. Our games were played on a playground in the city park across town. The visitor side, probably seated maybe 1,000, the home side, the visitor side maybe 500. The playing field was real dirt. You would be hard pressed to find a blade of grass on that playground that we referred to as our football field. So it was real dirt. I'll paste my notes for folks to hang on. Each player purchased his own shoes, and each player purchased his own jersey. And there was a little issue regarding the jerseys. They came a few days before our first game. They didn't have numbers on them. So our moms got some scrap material and cut out numerals and sewed numbers on the jerseys. I went home on a Friday afternoon with my jersey and didn't know what my number was going to be, and I had to be careful not to duplicate what some of the other guys had chosen. You know, we didn't get the directions of organization on how to do this. So didn't want to cost my mom so much trouble. So I thought 111 would be easy. So my number, my greatest claim to fame in athletics was having the number 111. And some folks refer to it as Roman numeral 3. So you can take your choice.
What a taste.
Now, the, our pads and our helmets were ancient. They had to need to be repaired every few days during the season. The helmets were soft leather and probably gave more protection than your toboggan if you could keep it on your head. There was no chin strap. It was really, really important that fans planning to attend a football game in Boaz be sure to use the restroom before we left home. There was no mystery about why the players formed a circle behind the bleachers. We did that quite often. We formed a circle. There was no insurance to cover sports injuries. All schools, large and small, were in the same classification, one classification. In 1947, we were forced to get to the state basketball tournament in Tuscaloosa. We beat Pleasant Home pretty handily the first game. The second game, we met Murphy High School in Mobile. At that time, Murphy High School in Mobile was the largest high school in the state. The enrollment at Boaz High, we graduated 23 in our class that year. Murphy High beat us by just one point, so that was quite a compliment. We had no assistant coach all the years I was a student at Boaz High School. No assistant coach. Can you imagine one person coaching a football team? That's unbelievable. But per facilities, per equipment, per training, lack of coaching were of absolutely no concern to us. We didn't give a second thought. We just wanted to play on a team. And being a member of a team was our ticket to our place in the sun. And we might get the attention of a girl. Thankfully, as all of you know, coaching expertise and training and the skill level and the training of all athletes and the facilities of all sports in the last 65 to 70 years have improved beyond belief, and that's really wonderful, the improvements that we look around and see in all of the high schools and Lord Grace also today. It's a tremendous honor for me to be inducted into the Marshall County Sports Hall of Fame. I'm humbled to be counted among so many great athletes, that's the other sense of thing. I'm humbled to be numbered among so many great athletes. I've been blessed with a great family, including my late wife, three wonderful children, eight grandchildren, and soon the fourth great grandchild. I continue to receive so much more from life than I deserve, including observing my 90th birthday this last month and tonight being inducted into the Marshall County Sports Hall of Fame. And I want to thank you for that honor. Thank you.